I've been fishing now for about 45 years. And in that 45 years, every time I go out, I learn something new. This week, I'm at Lac Mistianissini in northern Quebec, and I've learned a new technique on how to find fish in large bodies of water. I'm Bill Spicer, this is The New Fly Fisher.
The New Fly Fisher has been made possible thanks to James Bay Tourism, Orvis Sporting Traditions,
This week, our destination is in Quebec at the majestic Mistianissini Lake and through the rapids of the Rupert River. Located in the very heart of Lake Mistianissini is Osprey Lodge. The lodge has 5 log cabins and a capacity of 4 people per cabin. The lodge offers both American and housekeeping plans. Charming and equipped with propane stoves, refrigerators, lighting, running water, and wood stoves for heat. 4 species can be targeted in the area: lake trout, pike, walleye, and their number one species, brook trout. A rustic appeal blended with modern amenities will ensure that your vacation at Osprey Lodge is both comfortable and memorable. The first day we ran into wet weather and the fishing was slow. When that happens, I tend to swallow my pride and troll. You can cover a lot of water in a very short time, and it can mean the difference between success or failure.
See what we got. I'm not sure what we got yet. Speckle. And get your net, please. Thank you. Now, these are very dark fish. Hold on. Boy, he's full. That, look at how dark that is. This must be just what they are living in, the dark water. But that's about a pound and a half, maybe. Nice fish. Very, very, very nice.
We continued trolling until our guide found what they call a fish highway. This was new to me, and I asked him what he meant. He explained this is where multiple currents meet and the water is very calm. You can easily see this calm water as it looks like a highway. Most of the food, such as insects and small bait, is collected in this area, which then attracts brook trout and lake trout.
There we go. Fish on. Oh, good fish too. Good fish. Get it on the reel. Try to manage the line. Come on, staying down. Boy, oh boy, this is fun. Finding these slicks. We had to troll until we found them. Oh, it's a good size one. Yeah. Wow, he's going all over the place. I'm a believer now, sir. I'm a believer. Come here, you. Tire him right out. Jason, can I get you to net that, please? Yeah, come on, you. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Oh, that is a wonderful fish. Just a wonderful fish. Now, that's what I call a brook trout. They're very dark around here. As you can see, very black. The water is dark, but that is a wonderful, wonderful fish. Excellent, excellent. One more quick look. Very nice brook trout, very nice.
We'll be right back. The equipment needed when coming to Osprey Lodge are 9-foot number 6 weight rods for the trout. Also bring a 9-foot number 9 weight rod for the large pike in the area. Matching reels with smooth drags are a must, as the fish here are quite large. The lines needed are weight forward floating lines for trout, and the pike taper floating line for casting large flies needed for the pike. Intermediate trout lines with full sinking trout lines are also recommended. All fishermen have a vital tool at their disposal. That is the power of observation. Allow yourself to learn from others.
I've watched the spin fishers around here, and their retrieve is really fast. The fish seem to like it. So there's no finesse in here. You just make it go fast. Fish on. Whoa, yeah. Found another slick. Found another slick. Now, I don't like turning my back on the camera. Whoa, we have another large fish. Another large fish. Another brook trout. Another brook trout. Outstanding fishing here, outstanding. I'll let my guide here, see if I can get the fish up. Got him, good man. All right. Oh, and the fly pops out. It's actually bigger than the last one, longer anyways, but a much skinnier fish. Look at that. Oh my, isn't that something? Look at that. I'm impressed at how dark they are. Yeah. Yeah, see that? Yeah. Okay. And. Oh, this is, when away goes and I get a bath. Now, we're right in the middle of the slick. They show up, there's ripply water, and then you see still water. That's what you're looking for, and that's where the fish are gathering. Apparently, I guess underneath, it's gathering all the bait, all the bugs, and that's where these fish are. So that's what we've been doing. This is great, this is a lot of fun.
The average size of the brook trout in the area are between 1 and 3 pounds, with many reaching 5 pounds. And the occasional lunker up to 8 pounds has been reported. The brook trout prosper in a temperature that is generally below 54 degrees Fahrenheit and matched with clean, well-oxygenated water. The Mistianissini system has both of these important ingredients, which is why brook trout are so abundant here.
We're in 19 feet of water. That's incredible to me. So they're up near the top, you find these slicks. It makes all the difference in the world. For some reason they're active here. And these fish are taking emergers. I just gotta find out which one. And there we go. Yeah. Another good fish, another really, really excellent fish. And I can't get him on the reel because he keeps running at me. But I saw this fish rise in this slick in front of us here. Outstanding. This is a brand new technique to me. I've never ever done this, and I will always remember it. It's a nice thing about fly fishing. You learn something new every day. Now, yesterday we tried fishing and it was about 45 degrees Fahrenheit and it was just too cold. Today it's up around 49 to 50 degrees Fahrenheit, which makes a big difference in the fish. And there we go. Not quite as big as those other ones, but beautiful. He's got a little mark on him, looks like he's been hit. Don't know if that's a talon mark or what. Otter maybe. Anyway. And away he goes. And again, the slick in front of me, I saw the fish rise. And I'm sure it was that fish because it looked about the same size. And I cast it over by him and retrieved aggressively back and it chased it and hit it. So I'm not quite sure if they're coming up for insects or they're chasing bait to the surface in these areas here. But I'll figure it out before long and maybe try a dry fly over here or something. But right now I'm sticking with this leech pattern and it seems to be working for me.
The new fly fisher returns after these messages. Osprey Lodge is owned and operated by the Cree Nation and is a drive-to location, which is reflected in the cost of the trip. To ensure you get the week vacation you desire, make sure you book ahead at least 6 months in advance. The next day the weather had improved, so we decided to try for the legendary pike that inhabit the waters. I was not disappointed. When casting for pike, always finish off the stripping in of the fly right to the side of the boat. Pike are generally the highest predator on the lake and have no fear of most anything, and that includes boats. Many large fish are taken within a few feet of the side of the boat.
I don't know how big, it feels big. Really shaking. Okay. Whoa. Staying down. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Wowee. Big pike here. Oh, man. Wow. Look at the bend on the rod. This is a 9-weight rod. Oh yeah, this is a big fish. Oh wow, this is what you call a pike. Okay, get him out from under there. Oh, there he goes. Oh man, oh, now that's what I call a pike. Look at that, outstanding. And they're all over this bay. Very nice pike, very nice pike. Boy, oh boy, that was exciting. This cove is just full of nothing but big, big pike. And we're just on our way back to the camp for supper and thought we'd stop for some fun. Yeah, boy, that was fun. See if I can get one more.
There's an old saying, you may find structure without pike, but you will never find pike without structure. This structure may be an underwater hump, the edge of a weed line, a felled tree, an isolated rock, or anything man-made, such as a dock. Today we had success at the edge of weeds.
Oh yeah, right on it. Oh man, I didn't see him. I just cast it blindly. Wow. Is this ever a lot of fun? These are majorly big pike. In one concentrated area, I'm surprised. Oh wow. Look, oh well. Pike are so much fun. They fight so hard. See why they're called a water wolf. And you gotta have the tackle to match him. I wouldn't wanna try this with a 6-weight. And they've done all, pike always do this. They roll and wrap themselves up. Have to net him. I was going to try to get him myself, but I'm going to have to net him. And there we go. Not really big, but vicious. Just vicious. That's a small one here, and that by anybody's means is a nice pike. There you go. And he'll go on the bottom and sulk there until he recovers. And that was unreal. That was unreal. Why this bait attracts so many big fish, I have no idea. We were in a bay earlier, I got one decent sized fish and the other ones were small. Here they're all big for some reason.
Don't go away, we'll be right back. Flies that worked best for me on this trip were, for the trout, an articulated black leech, the Clouser minnow in chartreuse, and one in white and black. Also, a size 8 Kaufman stone nymph. For pike, I used a large green deceiver in the 6 to 8 inch size, and had particularly good luck with a red and white bunny leech at least 6 inches long. After a fantastic afternoon of pike fishing, we decided to go and find another fish highway and try for more trout.
Fish on. Fish on, right? Oh yeah. In the rocks here, and I was getting a little discouraged, but looks like I got one here. Decent one too. On the leech pattern again, and it's a brookie. It's a good size brookie, yeah. Wow, nice fish. The brook trout fishing here is really quite spectacular. And not easy at all times, but worth it. They got so many places here for you to go. They got two lodges, one that they use early in the year, and then the second one, when the winds pick up, they move across the lake to another one called Joliet. So I'll see if I can get the fish over to the net. Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Now, the fly popped out, which is barbless, which is nice. Put that back on. It's that same leech that I've been using all along. They seem to like the leech. Very nice, brook trout. Very nice. Okay. Well, I'll get him back in the water. Well, Barry gets the GoPro ready. Oh, well. He went out, did it by net. Sometimes you have those days that you can't do anything right. And I'm having one of those days. I wanted to get ready for the cameraman to do an underwater shot, and I put the fish back in so he won't die on me, and he just got right out of this net. Oh well. Fish on. Oh yeah. Oh, he's taking some line out. Fishing these highways, they call them, and under foam. If you look out on the water there, you'll see the foam. That's where I hit them. And I'm using a leech pattern, which they seem to like around here. And I'm stripping it on and off, fast and slow, fast and slow. And this one just hammered it. Yeah, it's a lake trout. Look at that. That's a bonus for me. This is where you need a good drag, because you can run into big fish here. There are 20 and 30 pound lake trout around here. So this one looks not quite that big, but it's a good one. Like I say many times before, I never met a fish I didn't like. So excellent, excellent. And nice lake trout. Excellent. Gray trout, they call them. Excellent eating, but this guy's a lucky guy. It's his lucky day. Now that's excellent. Lake trout now, I was hoping for a lake trout, and they're mixed all together. So it could be a box of chocolates type of fishing. Other than the pike, we have to go elsewhere for the pike, but you don't know if you're gonna get a walleye, you don't know if you're gonna get a brook trout, you don't know if you're gonna get a lake trout, which is kind of neat, I like that. Well, like all fishing trips, time to go home. My time has come. I'd like to thank the Cree Nation of Mistissini for hosting us this week. We had a wonderful time. For more information on this show and others in our series, visit us on the web at thenewflyfisher.com. From all of us here at The New Fly Fisher, thanks for joining us. Tight lines, we'll see you next week.
The New Fly Fisher has been made possible thanks to
James Bay Tourism,
Orvis Sporting Traditions,